Welcome back, First Hour Faithfuls, for yet another episode of the First Hour. This is the show where I, Colin Tanner from Video Games Are Dumb, and you, the legions of First Hour Faithfuls, take a look at the first hour of a recently released video game. So remember to like, subscribe, share, and bring the fire in the comments below for this episode, Blood Bowl 2 on the PlayStation 4. This is based off of the tabletop game Blood Bowl from Games Workshop, and this is the sequel now on current generation, Blood Bowl 2. Now, I've actually never played a Blood Bowl game before, not tabletop, not video game, so I'm a little new to the world. Just from what I saw in the box, I was like, oh, that looks like Mutant League, but reading a little bit on the series, obviously because it's tabletop, it's a turn-based game. A turn-based football game. Interesting. And that looks fantastic right there. Wow. Okay. Well.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, that's quite the intro. Just look at these character designs right here. Tons of art. Very well done. We've got this big bulking guy right here, obviously a vampire of some sort. Just wow, this looks gorgeous. Hopefully this is what the game actually looks like. If not,
good evening to all you Cabal Vision viewers out there in the old world and beyond. I hope your crystal ball is fully charged. And if not, find yourselves a wizard and chain him to it. Because the 25-13 season promises to be one hell of a show, doesn't it, Bob?
It sure does. Oh, and iron, Jim.
Iron what, Bob? Your shirt?
Chains, Jim. Iron chains for chaining up your wizard. Iron is best. It's harder to enchant than steel or silver. Oh, and don't forget to break their fingers as well.
Thank you, Bob. Yes, fascinating. And we may come back to that later. In the meantime, all you sports fans should keep it here on brand new Cabal Vision HD. But what about all you new viewers who are joining us for the first time?
Like me?
How would you explain a game of Blood Bowl to someone who hasn't experienced the joy and delight of it before, Bob?
Firstly, I'd say, under what toilet in the realm of chaos have you been hiding? Then I'd begrudgingly explain that Blood Bowl is a visceral, violent sport where two teams of players must get an inflated pig bladder or ball across a large field into the opponent's end zone by any means necessary to score a touchdown. The catch? There's only one ball, and the opposing team is trying to do exactly the same thing. A match lasts for two halves of eight turns. The team with the most touchdowns wins.
Very nicely summed up, Bob. So, what about the teams? It promises to be an interesting season, especially for the Reichland Reavers. Let's remind ourselves by taking a quick look what happened in their final game last year.
All right, we finally get a look at the game. Hopefully it looks somewhat like what we've just seen in that introduction, because that was gorgeous, absolutely beautiful. Lots of just very thoughtful design on each character. Good voice acting as well. Animation wasn't great, but what are you gonna do? I mean, they were a bit stiff, but I don't know. I guess vampires are technically dead, so there's always that. I'm just optimistic that the game itself will somewhat resemble that in terms of graphics. It does.
Reavers versus the gouged eye. Just look at those human lumps. Why ain't they moving?
A frozen spell. Could they not just let it all go?
Look at player 16. Josh Kirchner. He just stands there, lets that block fork smack him right in the kisser. Useless.
They don't seem this sprightly enough. Do they?
I know. No wonder this team hasn't won anything in 20 years. There's only so many double skull throws you can take. Fans start claiming that's a load of steaming bull.
Oh, no. That was the Reavers' last public appearance, summing up 10 seasons of decline.
Very impressive graphics right there.
Why haven't they been fired yet, Jim?
Not great animations, though.
The word is, Bob, that J.J. Griswell Jr. hasn't got the cash to replace them.
Yeah? Oh, Griswell was once said to be even richer than you, Jim. He's now down to his last few pennies after paying the likes of Griff Oberwald his massive wage for several decades. I guess he'll just have to put up with using last season's dregs. Anyway, enough yapping. Let's see how they do in this preseason match.
All right. Yeah, that lip sync is just not working there. They're not even remotely matching. But, the personable designs on each of those characters
well,
more than makes up for that.
Well, let's see how the Reavers get on. It's their first match under the leadership of the new coach in a preseason friendly.
Never use the word friendly in connection with Blood Bowl, Jim. You'll end up getting sued for false advertising. Okay, let's take a look.
Lots of personality there. Lots of comedy. It's quirky. I'm enjoying that. Obviously, there's going to be a level of violence to this game because it's called Blood Bowl. Now, I'm interested to see how well they're going to communicate the turn-based aspects, the rules, and the mechanics of this game. Because I don't think I've ever played a turn-based sports game. Ever. Let alone one that involves orcs and vampires. That's new. Oh, sound stops, so obviously it's... Okay,
welcome
loading times
back.
Aren't great.
Oh dear, this is a totally unfortunate. I can't understand what they're even doing on the same field.
Something tells me we're going to do okay this season. Something tells me that. So we're playing as human beings on this team. What's the opposing team going to be? Just more human beings. Just look at the crowds in the background, the detail on those statues. It's just wonderful. Just great art fully realized in 3D characters. Love the look of the grass here. There's a sense of realism, realism. It looks fantastic. Pretty long grass, isn't it, for a sport?
They're adaptable and tasty, but they can't always specialize to the degree that you...
I am Helmut Zwimmer, former coach of the Reavers, but just by the way, the font on the screen, way too small. And I will assist you during your initiation. To give you a little help, I use my connections and your first matches will follow simplified rules. Blood Bowl is a strategic sport and all starts with good player positioning. Each player has a movement allowance characteristics which indicates the number of squares that he may move. Okay. Each turn, each of your players can carry out an action with the X. Alright. Let's select a player. We select this big guy right here.
Is that... Oh, no, it can't be. In the Reaver's dugout, isn't that the legendary ex-coach, Helmut Zwimmer?
Sure is, Jim. Didn't you know, as a favor to JJ, Zwimmer's come out of retirement to mentor the new coach for the first...
Looks like I can select anywhere,
and what about that incident
even
that
beyond this
to
line.
Leave in the first place?
What? That tabloid sting in 04? Involving a pair of halflings, Jam, and a confused hippogriff? Oh, that was nothing. Nothing was proven.
Okay.
Well, he's certainly experienced. The new head coach should listen to his advice.
I've already performed an action on this player. Okay. The blitz allows players to move and block. This action may only be carried out once per turn. Well, we got another guy down. Why don't I just take out the whole team? I've already performed a blitz. Okay, so the blitz carries across the entire team, not just individual players, which is cool by me. So that means I need to focus on my blocking ability. So we're gonna get a block right there. So the ball is just right there, eh? It looks like something like a quarterback, so we're going to go over there.
Ah, good. He's got the ball.
Just want to put it real quick.
They fumbled that bit.
You can't control this with the D-pad. You have to control with the analog stick, and that does not... doesn't feel great. Well, I want to pass it off to somebody. Am I able to perform that action right now? Quick pass to this guy.
They pass the ball, but will it be a completion? Great pass, but can they capitalize?
I suppose I would like to get over here. 83% that I could actually get there. So, yeah. Mostly thanks to hurting those other players. What is this exactly? I can move one more space? Is that what they're saying? Yes. Then I will move one more space. Feel free to try different types of actions after finishing with your player. You can press triangle to end your turn. Okay, then. I've already used your pass action. Okay. Well, then I want to take out this guy. These guys aren't really putting up much of a fight. And honestly, I feel kind of bad now. I've already used my blitz action. But we're not blitzing anymore because the ball has been passed. Okay, whatever. I guess I'll just get that guy over there. Get this guy over there.
Not a wise place to end your turn on the border of the pitch. If the player gets pushed into the crowd, well, the last time that happened, it took 3 days to piece the body back together.
Okay, is that strategy or a joke? Because I honestly can't tell at this point. So hopefully that had a point. Okay, whoops, accidentally hit. Looks like the triggers are to zoom out the camera. You can't actually move the camera in any other direction. You can just move it like this. Which, to be frank, is kind of useless in an isometric game.
On the edge of the field there, within grasping range of the fans, and they're looking hungry.
Alright, well, that looks like this guy could still do something. I guess I'll put him over here to block. Is that everybody? Well, we got one last action here. I've already used the blitz action. Do I want to end my turn? Yep. Alright, what's going to happen now? That's not good, but okay, that's a start. There goes.
Remember, you need balls to score.
Interesting that no one's attacking him just yet. Really? Huh. I could have sworn somebody would have. Is this a touchdown? 83% that I'm gonna get a touchdown?
Should have seen.
Well, I guess that 17% really. Really won out there. Let's get this guy over to the ball. 67% that he's gonna be able to dodge.
The other statue with such easy prey. I may sit down myself. I fancy a bite.
I don't want to pass the ball. So I'm gonna deselect that. What about A3% that he'll make that. 17% really shining today. 17% doing a great job. A3% really not.
That player's going for it.
Alright, well, let's just see if I can pass the ball over here. You've already performed an action on this turn. Can he still pass, though? So he can't be passed to. That's unusual. He was able to pass earlier. I guess it has to be in succession. Is what I'm assuming here. Not really sure. I guess if that's the case. 67%. 37% just dominating out there. Alright. That will have to do. I'm just gonna get him to stand up. Guard from the front. Kind of ridiculous that he was even able to attack from that distance. Once again, real bad day for 37%. I'm kind of worried about what this guy could pull off, so we're just gonna put a stop to that right now.
And that's our one.
Looks like he's able to perform another maneuver. What about that? No.
Don't forget to pick up your team.
Didn't actually see the action that took place just then. I don't know. Okay, well. This guy's being a real jerk. Nope, already used Blitz. So. 67%. What if I want to go right behind this guy? 83% chance I'll make it. Interesting.
Ouch! That must have hurt.
Real bad luck. If you got 17%, don't go for it. You know, it's gonna catch up to you. Alright. Who else we got left on the team that has not moved yet? So this guy is this... Alright. I guess that's going to have to do it for the turn.
I can't see Reaver star player and Captain Griff Oberwald on the field, General. Where's the mighty Zog? Why is he not ripping Lyman's heads off our shoulders? I thought Lyman's quota was severely... Why are they not here?
Haven't you heard, Bob? Ever since his men's fragrance, Gruff by Griff, flopped, he hasn't been seen all off-season. Rumor has it his investors are not happy and want their money back.
I tried some of that scent. What was he thinking? I'm an ogre, and even I couldn't stand the smell. I'd rather take a drag from a goblin's crotch than wear that. What about Zog? Why isn't he here?
Zug's so disgusted with the Reaver's performance. But if a Reichland legend like Helmut Zwimmer is back, well, you never know.
I don't like it, Jim. The whole point of watching the Reavers is the glorious devastation and maiming left in Zug's wake. Grah! I love a good maiming. Get something
well,
to score a touchdown.
Yeah, that was a touchdown.
First touchdown. The other team must wake up.
The models look pretty good again, but the animations, that's a little awkward.
That was a short game.
Looks like the Saints have chickened out. Reavers win by default. That's the
wow.
Game to win all season. I won't be sure.
I don't really feel like I have a grasp on what's going on yet. Hopefully, the next tutorial is going to go into more detail. If there is another tutorial.
Well, would you look at that? The Reavers won!
Yeah, but the Saints whipped out early.
Hold on! I have shocking news. JJ has fired the whole Reaver squad!
Not that shocking, Jim. Griswold's having a clear-out before the 25-13 season gets underway. One default win against no-hopers like the Saints ain't gonna cut it. He should have done it sooner.
So if the whole squad's been sacked, where's this new coach going to find his team, Bob?
JJ's a cunning old devil, Jim. My contacts say he can get a whole squad of fresh-faced wannabe new players from the rejects found on that reality Cabal Vision show, Reichland Ain't Got Talent.
It sounds like a risky strategy to me, Bob.
Risky, Jim? I've seen snotlings come up with more competent plans.
All right, so recruit a new team. Everybody, please don't take a screenshot here. Okay. Send to recruit a new team and sign with a sponsor. Access your team's management page by pressing Exot's emblem. Okay. Let's buy a player. You're about to recruit a team to restore the image of the Greenlack Reavers. Team is made up of at least 11 players. Try to balance a group with all types. Catchers, thrower, blitzer, and org. Whoa. I was accidentally selecting players. Wait. Cancel purchases. Yep. You could actually purchase players while that other screen... while that other screen was over the screen. Not sure I understand why that was. Okay, so let's get... well, all these guys. Why would I not do that? Well, we don't really need two throwers. So let me just... okay, interesting. There's no way to actually remove any of the players, you just have two. So do two catcher, one thrower, three blitzers, lineman, org. Maybe just one more thrower, and... one more blitzer there. Okay, sounds good to me. Confirm purchase.
How's this new coach doing so far, Bob?
Well, he managed to put some names in the roster so far, Jim. I wouldn't call them contenders for the Chaos Cup.
Why does the screen even go dark? I don't understand it. Given the current situation of the team, no serious sponsor will blah blah blah. Alright. Let's go to the
Stadium
club.
Is like a second home for a team.
I guess we don't have a sponsor, so we're signing
Deal's
with them.
Done. Contract signed. The Reichland Reavers have a sponsor.
I only hope they read the small print, Bob. I remember I once signed a contract to get eternal life. It sounded so simple. But the whole craving blood, dread vampire curse thing? Well, that wasn't in 12-point Helvetica, I can tell you.
Alright, let's play that match.
Welcome back, sports fans. And who'd have thought we'd be covering this game, Bob?
I'm as excited as a snotling in a pump wagon, Jim. If the rumors are true, the Reavers have finally got a sponsor. Well, subject to contract negotiations.
That's true, Bob. It's not set in stone yet. But the newly reformed NAF are certainly putting pressure on them to get funding. Gone are the days when any Targ, Dieter, or Harbinger can turn up with a team of nobodies. With Cabal Vision HD comes money, and so you'll need the gold to get in. Even a franchise with as much history as Reichland. So, who have they got?
An outfit called Parstown X3.
Never heard of them.
They manufacture bell polishing cream. They're not big corporate players, Jim. That's a sponsor the Reavers wouldn't even have considered in their heyday. But beggars can't be choosers.
Alright, so hopefully we'll get a better grasp of exactly how this game plays in this one. I mean, all I really knew is to knock down their players and run around them. Like, it's basically football. Basically, you know, except you're able to just knock down players. I'm not sure. There's like a lot of stats going on here, but the Rodders have given away fewer touchdowns than any other team. Load times are pretty brutal on here. That's one thing that has to be pointed out.
Welcome back, sports fans.
Great art.
It's
always great art.
Versus humans. Greenskins versus men. An endearing lineup and always a guarantee of hope. One team is obviously more skilled than the other. It's hard.
Oh dear. This is getting real right here. We're in deep shit. I don't think we're gonna be able to just punch those guys over. Oh good, they just get bigger. That's good. Just, yeah, go ahead, get bigger. Alright, so, you know, it's just like 9 foot tall ogres. Not a big deal.
Orcs are hard, brutal opponents. You can also handle the ball.
You gotta be smarter or stronger. That's the way to beat.
Your recruits have style, but we'll see what they're capable of against this orc team. This game highlights the block and essential aspect of Blood Bowl. As you can see, each of your players has a strength characteristic. It allows an advantage to be gained over an opponent in a block action.
Greenskins.
Well, better get the ball. So I'm the thrower. All right, I'm getting a little bit more into the stats here. Is this my lineman right here? That's my blitzer. That's my blitzer. There's my lineman.
That's a pass no amateur could attempt. Only a pro can manage a play like that.
Alright, I'm not sure what the dice mean. But my strength is at 3, his strength is at 3, he's a level 9 or whatever, but, okay, sure, let's go for it. This dice is a block dice, it determines success or failure of your actions. If these dice are white, it is attacker who chooses which one applies. If they are red, it's the defender. The defending player is pushed back and then knocked down. What? Follow. Alright, well, if that's the case, then... Shit, I... Nope, don't do that. Guess we'll go right there and block him.
Get in their face!
I've got the ball, don't I? 83% chance that I'll totally make it. So, what is exactly going on here? Why him falling over? I don't understand that. Random falling, never a good idea in a video game. Just pointing that out for you, okay? Well, who should I worry about at the moment? I guess there's these guys that could possibly get in his way. Another bad day for 37%, or great day for 37%, bad day for 67%. It just seems that if you have the ball, you have a lot of advantage here.
Will the big one manage to lay out an opponent of half his strength?
No, we both got hurt. Alright, interesting. Okay, that's a little bit more balanced.
That's it. Force him back and then pow!
I guess I'll just try and get these guys closer to the action here. Because I am not really sure. So it's not like he's tripping over bodies or anything. Okay.
The other birds stood there like stones, with such easy prey. I may swoop down myself. I fancy a bite.
Oh, we got one more guy over here. Try to get him to block over here.
Impossible to tackle. The humans will love it.
One step too far. All right, let's end the turn. A lot of players getting back up, it looks like.
Gobble's got the ball. That's not a bad thing. When they want to, goblins can be really hard to get a hold of.
Okay. I will say, I'm not sure if you can fast forward through your opponent's play. But if you can't, that's a pretty significant issue. Because while you do want to pay attention to their strategy, I'm not sure if that pace is necessary. So take that. You better believe.
I know, Jim. I'm watching the same match as you.
Interesting. Interesting. Very fortunate.
Good enough, the player could spit into the end zone.
I wonder if... Damn. Wanted to see if I could pass the ball more than I had before, but the answer is no. I'm just gonna hit this guy in the head. Well, or I guess I'll push him away. Huh. Very, very, very bad day for 67%. 37% just dominating out there. Oh, I'm sorry. 33%. Oh, shit. I'm insane. The wrong number for a long time. My turn, see what happens.
Get next to the ball carrier so you can block him. And if that doesn't work, stab him in the face. This player, the attacker, smells weakness.
That's gonna be trouble.
Ouch.
That's just random. Even if it happens to the other team, I'm not a big fan of it.
Spitting teeth about this.
He will spend his next turn recovering from it. All right. Really wish I could fast forward these parts. Maybe there is a way to do it. Settings, maybe something. Cutscenes. All? What? General cutscenes. Oh, if I want the cutscenes on. Okay, no. Nope.
Bell polishing cream. It's a strange choice of sponsor, Tim. I'll give you that. Orkidos, Murdy's, Bank of Altdorf, even Bloodweiser. None of the big corporations were interested. JJ took the chili off.
But now they've got financial backing, they can qualify for the new NAF. So here we are. Let's see how they do.
That player should punch the other enemy players quickly before trying anything else.
Yeah, I thought about that, but I don't know. 67%. Oh! Very bad day once again for all you fans. 33%.
I don't rate that player's chances of still standing at the start of the next turn. If they are... Oh, wait! Something's happening! Score!
Oh, no, Jim. I didn't miss the touchdown.
The music sounds really familiar. Alright, cool. Finally, we're playing defensive here. We're just gonna select that's where we want to kick.
My goodness. Normally, the fans aren't quite fearless. It takes them at least 3 to 4 games to get them properly psychotic.
Really can't stress how boring it is to watch their team play. It's kind of a chore, actually.
He seems a little stunned, doesn't he?
Hey, Jim, who's that weaselly kid hanging around the Reaver's dugout, staring daggers in the back of the coach?
You mean the goblin? The little fella? I think that's the new assistant. He used to work at Parstown.
A goblin working for a Humie team? Looks like these sponsors, these bell polishers, want more than just the name on the kit, Jim. It's every coach's worst nightmare when the sponsor wants to be involved.
Ball in danger! And carrier, too.
Just wanted to see what would happen if I actually selected that. I just got my own player knocked down. That was my only blitz action, so not great for me.
With fists flailing, he's following up, hoping to get the knockdown next time.
What can I attack now?
The bigger they are,
the harder they punch.
I'm confused here. Push back and then knock down. You got it. Sounds awesome for me.
With arms like tree trunks. There's only going to be one result in that.
I do want to get my team out there. Whew, 17% just dominating the field today. Ah, that mathematically hurts.
What a speedster!
I'm gonna use my blitz.
They'll need to get rid of the ball now there's pressure on them.
Well, I've already applied. Alright, let's see how far I can take this guy. So block from this position.
Don't forget to pick up your team.
Just tragic. Much like real sports, tripping, just knocking a player out. You know, that's really unfortunate. Tripping, you know, that's a reasonable expectation for any major sport, that people are just gonna fall down, knock themselves unconscious, especially twice in a row. That is bound to happen. That's why it's a risk and a gamble. That's why they got pictures of dice on there. Alright, where's this guy? Roll the dice right here. Oh!
It's going to be okay.
Three times in a row, and he slides back. Aw, just a tragedy right there. All too common in all major sports, though. That is what happens.
Haha, here's some friends.
Ooh, hurry up. Have them all move at once. I don't care. I get it, it's strategy, but
enough to come out on top.
Give me some options, you know what I mean?
That player's going for it.
All right. Gotta wake this guy up. Why not? Go for it, buddy.
If you can't run, don't try that kind of move.
We can run. What are you talking about?
Go, big guy. Trample all over him.
All right. Oh! Sudden kick takes him down, don't you dare. Oh, already used my blitz action.
They've left the counter exposed. There could be a counter strike.
I'm certain nothing will go wrong before the next turn.
No, I don't want to pass to him. Is there anybody I can pass to? Not really. I mean, let's roll the dice, see if I make it. I mean, 83%. What's worse that could happen? Oh, you don't expect to see that.
On the floor again.
Oh.
This must be like worms or something.
Why is that guy running there? Why is no one going for the ball? Alright, just walk over and pick up a ball.
hard now.
You know, using the same model over and over again for the cheerleaders and the animation not looking exactly great, that's pretty awkward. All right, there we go.
Now you tell me, isn't that an ogre down there? Instigating it? That big fellow wearing the suit and the shades.
Oh, that's one of the bossy plumbers. You don't mess with them, Chum. Not unless you want your vital bits pulled off and eaten in front of your wife. They're not that cuddly type of ogre like Morgan Thorg. You won't see them on the front of a cereal box or doing road safety commercials.
Name rings a bell. Weren't the Kabasi brothers investors in British aftershave emporium?
Griff screwed over the Kabasi brothers? No wonder he's hiding.
What, is it my turn now? For real? Okay. I didn't know. Alright.
In these conditions, it's
I might be able to pull out something. I guess I'll have to be in that direction.
I wasn't interested. And by the looks of things, neither were they.
Oh, he's got the ball over there. I'm gonna have to sprint down here. That guy's already knocked out. I mean, I'll roll the dice on this one.
Oh.
Brutal. Brutal slipping. I get what the dice mean now. I mean, that's... I get what they mean. But it is a little bit slow. It's a wee bit slow there.
Spending an awful amount of time on the ground.
I'm just gonna end that turn right there. I don't know why you would choose to move directly where I am. I mean, unless this is all just part of the tutorial. Which is nice, but not sure how well it's educating me. Oh wow, that guy's up. I thought he was like stunned. I'll play him back up over here for him.
That player is about to get punched above and below the belt at the same time. That last burst of speed. It's risky.
Wow, I didn't even see him. Okay, well, if that's the case, then I'm going to make this guy. Well, okay. First things first. I've got pretty good odds already.
All this focus on the ball is against the spirit of the game. Give me more random violence. That's the way. Kill him.
Did we already get the ball? Who just picked up? That guy already picked up the ball. Then he's gonna go over here.
An unmolested enemy in the end zone? Not my day.
Let's see if we can make the pass.
What a great thing! Touchdown!
No! We're at the halfway point of the game. If the losers are gonna make a move, they need to do it now.
Ha ha ha! Is there really no way to skip that? All right, you got to press start.
They kick the ball to the opponents. Now it's time to think defensively.
Well, that's the eighth turn, so it should be wrapping up the game after this turn.
That little creature's pretty
hard. He's got the ball, but it doesn't really matter.
It can be thrown by a troll. Doesn't really work often.
I mean, it would take three touchdowns, and it's not really possible right now. That was it. Oh. Two halves of eight turns. Got it.
Important thing, you gotta keep possession of the ball and not lose it. A strike back would be terrible.
No, I don't. If I stay right here, it won't get a touchback. But I'm gonna risk that. Just to see what happens. Well, it lands exactly wherever I want.
That little creature's pretty hard to tackle, you know. And it can be thrown by a troll. Doesn't really work often, but it's funny.
That's gonna take care of that guy. We'll try this out. Nothing wrong with that. Holy crap. Incredible.
He's now free as a fart in a thunderstorm.
Do you select the player?
There's nothing better than hitting someone smaller than you, Jim.
Definitely gonna have to go with the, once again, the knockout.
The dog wins the fight. Not this time.
Stunning a lot of their players right now.
Greased balls would struggle to dodge through that defensive lineup.
Worth the risk. Just had to see who was going to make it through. It's a gamble. It's a real big gamble, but I'm going to go for it again. Let's see if I can get around here. That's another big gamble. Here we go. Knew what I was getting into. Back out of that. I mean, you know, this is I'm kind of dominating the field right here. It's going to make it very difficult for him.
Stupid to trip up like that. Bad for your head, bad for your pride.
Well, okay then. Go right there. Do wish I could kind of skip up the animation. Because I don't really need to see the guy running over. And that turn, let's just see what happens before we call it quits here.
Yeah, smells like a good old-fashioned fight.
I really thought he was going to go for the pass. I'm actually pretty surprised he didn't. In fact, the defense is pretty much ignoring me.
Close and personal, Bob.
You need to be close. So close they can smell your breath and see the dead insects in your teeth.
Yeah, it's a risk. But I'm gonna go for it. See if I can get this to function correctly.
I love it when that happens. Rah! He's on him now, like a halfling on a hot dinner.
Alright, well then, if that's the case...
They're going for the ball!
Still having some trouble here. Oh! Taken out right away.
Player's a little short. Oh no, my mistake. He's on the ground.
He's not able to perform a blitz attack. I mean, really, this guy's surrounded at this point. Let's end the turn to see what happens. Sit through this. Oh, brutal.
If the Reavers come back, then this is the season to be.
All right.
Valvision HD has got the match-going public interested in Blood Bowl again. Ratings are up.
My ratings are up, Jim? Brilliant news. I can afford that Warpstone tooth now. Dental plans are so expensive.
That's right, Bob. Bigger ratings means more cash. We all know the team is stony broke. An influx of gold pieces into the game this season will help Rattland Reavers out of crippling debt.
Is crippling debt like crippling halflings, Jim?
No.
Because that's fun.
Sadly, no.
Oh. Well, I don't know.
Okay, well, that's going to do it for the first hour, because I think it's going to take longer to take it to get a touchdown than maybe I expected. Look, I've given Blood Bowl 2 a little more time than most other games. I know it's still the first hour, but I wanted to spend enough time just to make sure I understood the base mechanics. Here's what I'll say. They're sound. They're just not explained very well. Now that I have a better grasp on it, I can say that the core game itself is good. It is good. It's also unnecessary. Hold up. As a tabletop game, brilliant. Totally understand it. As a console game, as a PC game, not quite sure this is necessary. Now here's where you're really not going to be happy about what I have to say. As a mobile game, this makes a lot of sense. It's a turn-based game, and you can play it at your own pace. I would rather see this on, I don't know, the Vita, the 3DS, or even a phone way before I'd want to see it on a console. Yeah, that's probably not going to be a very popular opinion, but I can't rationalize why this is here. Like, why is this on the PS4? I like the art. I like the jokes. I think that the tutorial is bad. I don't think it does a good job of explaining how to play the game. Luckily, the game is pretty much pick up and play, so that's not horrible. But the overall feeling I get is like, yeah, you know, it's good. Love the art. Like I said, really, really love the art. Some of the best art of the year. That is beautiful. Animations, not so much. Lip sync, definitely not. It's just a shame that this doesn't feel like the right platform for it. But if you like what you saw, and you got a PS4, you got a PC, or whatever else this is on. Is this on Xbox One? I don't even know. Then, yeah, I'm sure it's worth your while to check it out. But for me, there's that nagging doubt in the back of my mind, like, ah, this is not the right place for it. But let me know what you thought in the comments below. Blood Bowl, play the first one, play the tabletop. I want to hear from you. That's about it. Thanks for watching this episode of The First Hour. I will see you next time. Like, subscribe, share, bring the fire in the comments below. And, yeah. Thanks for watching.